So here we go. Dragons of Tarkir, hit or myth. Are you ready for this, Raptor?
I'm ready.
Have you looked at the mythics?
I've seen them all.
I have a whole debate on this because I've done it where I've like taken a long time to study all the cards, and then had it where like 5 minutes before I just look, and it's weird. I like my gut on things because sometimes I think about it too long. I talk myself into this, talk myself into that. Anyway, so but I have looked at these. So
yeah, I think gut is the best way to judge.
Because kind of the myth side of it or the hit side of it, whether it's mythic.
Yeah, it should be the instant I open this card. For the first time I'm seeing it, is this a hit or a myth? Like, now, that's what we should be going for.
Let me get the ground rules straight here. People actually were tweeting us after the last one that we should change this. A hit means that the card is properly mythic. A myth means that
we really need to get away from those names are horrible.
Okay, lobby LSV.
Start
tweeting at LSV, because hit or myth was his baby.
Well, of course, it's a stupid pun. That just makes everything more confusing.
If you get LSV's permission to change the title of this to, I don't know what. Myth or mither. That's not
helpful either.
Up. Anyway, for now, for this hit or myth, we will stick with hit or myth. Hit, good. Myth, bad.
Just translate myth to miss and...
It'll all make sense to you. Okay, first up on Hit or Myth, Clone Legion. 2 blue, 7. For each creature target player controls, put a token onto the battlefield that's a copy of that creature. Raptor, hit or myth?
This is a myth. It's just not very interesting. Like,
wow! I thought this was a total hit.
Really?
I thought it was a total hit. Because I kind of picture it like, huge army, bam. Huge army faces identical huge army. It's got that feel to it to me.
Yeah, I guess my mind just translates that to Plague Wind. Like, essentially, you know, their creatures are all just trained for yours that you just make a copy of, so it's just an expensive Plague Wind. I don't know, it doesn't seem very exciting, and like...
You
know what this card needs for me to be a hit?
White and red in the mana cost, and then all of a sudden it's
No, it needs to copy every creature in play. Shouldn't be just one player, every creature in play.
That's fair. I mean, I agree that would make it more of a hit. But as it stands now, it's a hit for me. It's a myth for you, Raptor.
Yep.
Fair enough, it's a myth for you. All right, second up, Descent of the Dragons. 2 red, 4. Destroy any number of target creatures. There you go, any number. For each creature destroyed this way, its controller puts a 4/4 red dragon creature token with flying onto the battlefield.
So, I like this card. The problem is that Precedent has this card at rare.
Like, that's true.
This exact card existed in Rise of Eldrazi, minus the flying.
Right, right.
And it was a rare. So, like, is flying enough to move that same effect to mythic? Or, like, if you, like, trying to divorce, like, myself from what I've seen before, like I don't know.
Let me explain to you what's happening here. These creatures,
they all become dragons.
They turn into dragons.
Yeah, okay.
Man.
All right, dragons. It's a hit.
It's like all of these things are dragons now. That is a mythic.
Yeah.
You're a dragon. Everybody's a dragon. So to me, I saw. I'm like, okay, that's definitely a hit for me. Okay.
No, I agree. It's a hit.
Now, so here's the quandary, and this one's tough. We're gonna hit the dragon lords now. These are elder dragons, and so, it's really hard. Like thinking about the hit or myth. Oh, LSV says myth. You know what, Luis, if you want to do hit or myth, you make yourself available for Skype. Otherwise, this Monday morning armchair quarterbacking in the chat. I mean, come on, man, come on. And for the record, for all of you, Luis was definitely invited. Definitely invited. Was he not invited?
Yeah, he was.
Yeah. I thought, shouldn't you be working on a constructed set review, Luis? That's what I was told. So, all right. So the Dragon Lord, the whole quandary with the Dragon Lords was Elder Dragons kind of have a mythic side. I mean, we're talking way back to Legends these things were around. Not these exact Elder Dragons, but the Elder Dragons, you know, kind of introduced in Legends. So that was kind of my quandary looking at them all. But we'll start with Dragon Lord Atarka. 1 green, 1 red, 5 other. Flying Trample. When Dragon Lord Atarka enters the battlefield, it deals 5 damage, divided as you choose, among any number of target creatures and or planeswalkers your opponents control, and it's an 8/8. It's a pretty big dragon. It's going to do some damage. Thoughts on Dragon Lord Atarka, hit or myth?
Yeah, it's obviously a hit.
It's got to be, right?
Do you need any other information about these other than just knowing that they're the leaders of their broods, giant elder dragons.
That's my point.
Like,
it's legendary elder dragons.
Right? Like, does it matter what the card does at all? Like, what would the card have to be for one of these to be a myth?
I mean, it would have to be like vanilla. So if Dragonlord Tarka, no abilities but flying,
just
8/8.
7 mana, 8/8 flying trample. I think it's still a hit.
It's really
tough. it doesn't matter what the card does.
That's the problem with this hit or myth. They're all friggin' elder dragons, like back to legend status.
I mean, I guess you could give it myth. Like, well, come on, that really doesn't feel like it
does anything.
It should be an elder dragon.
You're not gonna do that for a 7 mana, 8/8. I'll tell you that much. 7 mana, 8/8 flying trample. This thing is gonna maul you. It's gonna maul the other dragons. It's gonna maul the other dragons and the dragon behind that dragon, and it's gonna kill the other ones that it didn't already maul. So, I mean, yes, Dragonlord Tarka, definite hit. Okay, next up, Dragonlord Dromoka. Dromoka. I'm gonna say Dromoka. You know, Dromoka Almond Fudge. White, green, 4/4 for a 5/7. Dragonlord Dromoka can't be countered. Flying, lifelink. Your opponents can't cast spells during your turn. I could have stopped very early on in the description of things that Dromoka does. And
yeah,
this guy's still
at flying lifelink is a clear hit.
Yeah.
The one problem I have with this card is that they can't be countered and opponents can't cast spells during your turn. Feels kind of wasted on this card. Just because, like, the counter spell decks, it's pretty rare for them to get in a spot where they need to counter with this anyway rather than just be able to kill it.
Sure.
And
sure. Yeah, that's
like,
true.
Like, if you put those two abilities on something cheap, then you have something really interesting because then you get, like, an effect where you have your whole turn free to be able to have your way with the control with the counterspell deck.
Right.
But on a 6-mana spell, well, no. You've already spent your whole turn.
That's a great point. We're in a whole new world where the counterspell issue isn't as important as the target removal issue.
Right. Like, yeah, because you're not facing decks with 20 counterspells.
Right, exactly.
Against something like that, this would be absurd.
Right, right.
But you're playing against 4 counterspells and 20 things that kill creatures.
Definitely. No, that's a huge point. Yeah. I mean, Hex, it's weird. In Modern Magic, Hexproof is a better protection ability in a control type situation or against control than uncounter abilities.
Yeah, by a lot.
By a huge mile. You all probably knew that. Raptor clearly did, but to me, it's a bit of a revelation. I hadn't changed my thinking that way. But that's very, very, that's enlightening. But nevertheless, still a hit.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, you could have those two abilities on just, you know, some 2-mana 2/2, and it would feel like a hit.
Yes.
Like, that would work for me as a mythic.
Definitely.
Like, that effect is super powerful. It's just kind of, like, wasted on a 6-mana creature.
Mm-hmm. 5/7/2, I mean, you know, stats. I mean, I like Silumgar, the original Silumgar, but I dragons that have higher defense than offense to me always feel a little bit wrong. I'm just gonna say that it just never feels quite right for me. But whatever. Dragonlord Kalaghan, 1 red, 1 black, 4/4 for a 6/5, flying, haste. Other creatures you control have haste. Whenever an opponent casts a creature or planeswalker spell with the same name as a card in his or her graveyard, that player loses 10 life. I'm not sure how relevant I find that final ability.
I really dislike that the final ability is limited to creature or planeswalker.
Yeah.
If it just said any spell.
Well, that would be insane, though, Josh. Would
it be too good?
Ten you?
Okay, make it any spell and make it like 5U.
Your second anticipate, I'm going to ten spot you.
Well, I would recommend not casting that anticipate.
Yeah.
I mean, 10 is a lot.
10 is a lot.
Ten is definitely a lot.
I mean, if you have a way.
But what if it's just 6 or 5, like, and it's any spell?
Five or six seem like a lot to me too.
I think
to get to any spell, you'd have to be like 3.
No, you could definitely do 6. That would be a totally printable card.
Okay, let me ask you this. We agree it's a hit, so I'm going to go off the beaten path here for a second.
Like, compare that to like a Heroic Thar.
No, I still think 5's too good.
They still have to have the card in their graveyard already.
Well,
it's not like you're just getting them for any spell they play.
If it's any spell, not just creature, just any spell. At what life total damage would it have to be before you start looking at like millstones or their equivalent?
There's no amount that's gonna be relevant.
So if I mill you and you play that card again,
I'm not playing like Bot Scour or Tomb Scour. If it's like 20 damage, that's still not gonna get me to play mill.
Huh.
I mean, if there's like reasonable things like thought scouring my opponent, then I might put that into my deck.
But actually putting it into your no glimpse of the unthinkables nothing like that.
No, it could be 20 damage, still not going to that.
Raptor, you are no fun, man. All right, here's your favorite Dragon Lord Ojutai, 1 blue, 1 white, 3 other for a 5/4 flying. Dragon Lord Ojutai has hexproof as long as it's untapped. Whenever Dragon Lord Ojutai deals combat damage to a player, look at the top 3 cards of your library. Put one. Anticipate. Yep. I think those, you get to anticipate. You have experience with Ojutai.
Yeah.
You
have positive experience. I didn't get to actually play with Ojutai at all.
Oh, get out of here!
I only had Ojutai's commands.
Oh, well, that which is very good.
Well, yeah.
Okay. So, Dragon Lord Ojutai.
Yeah, this is a hit among hits, and I'm not just saying that because of brood bias.
Right. Which there clearly is here, by the way.
I admit to that, but. Accepting that, like, this is just so much, like, a perfect flavor fit for the Ojutai Brood compared to all these others. Like, these others are, like, impressive giant dragons, but they don't really encapsulate what their brood is about.
Uh-huh.
Ojutai does.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's true. The only thing I'll say is Atark is just big and impressive.
Okay.
And that part of it, hit among hits, I mean, I think that, like, it's just, like, this thing is it's a dragon, so but yes, a definite hit, no question.
But having the prowess brood's dragon just cast anticipate whenever it hits them, like, that's awesome.
I mean, from a kind of a playability and theme perspective, it's unbelievable. So
though it would have been better if anticipate just cost blue white, it would be more like, it would be more flavorful. Like, obviously anticipate is a like themed as a Ojutai card but
what if it just flashbacked for blue white?
Well, let's be reasonable, Mashi.
White, what other? Fair enough. No, I agree. I think from a player perspective, it would be good that way. Or it could have been stuck on the command. Okay. Dragon Lord Silumgar. 1 black, 1 blue, 4 other for a 3/5 flying death touch. When Dragon Lord Silumgar enters the battlefield, gain control of target creature or planeswalker for as long as you control Dragon Lord Silumgar.
Yeah, the Sower of Temptation, your planeswalker, feels... unique enough that I definitely have that as a hit. You could put that on any costed creature, and it's going to be a hit for me.
This dude has Tassigir hanging from his neck.
Well, yeah.
How can he not be a hit?
Yeah.
You see this art? That's Tassigir's throne, and that's Tassigir hanging from his neck. That's what bananas get you. I mean, this guy is obviously a hit.
Yeah.
Stealing that planeswalker, stealing a creature, I mean, that it's so great. The Sower ability is awesome. The flying death touch, whatever. Tassigir. I mean, that's just, when I saw that, I was like, wow, all right, Flavor win. We got, there's a new king on the throne. So, definite hit there. Sorry, the Elder Dragons, not that much fun because, as I was getting to at the beginning, they're Elder Dragons, man. What are you going to do? We haven't seen these since Legends. All right, next up. Appropriately, with Raptor, Deathmist Raptor. 2 green, 1 for a 3/3 with Death Touch. Whenever a permanent you control is turned face up, you may return Deathmist Raptor from your graveyard to the battlefield face up or face down. The Raptor has Megamorph for 1 green, 4 other.
This is a myth for me. I like this card a lot for Constructed, but it just feels like, hey, this is a tournament card. Mm-hmm. There's no real flavor attached to it. It's not some... really unique effect. Like, yeah, it comes back from your graveyard. We've seen that in a million different things. It just happens to be a green card this time. Like, it's just not there for me.
Unquestionably agree with you. Absolute myth. Absolute myth. And it's always tough when it's like, yeah, this card looks like it's really good.
Yeah, but it is a really good card, but that doesn't make it mythic.
It doesn't mean it's mythic. Yeah. It doesn't have that mythic. There's nothing about this that has a mythic feel. There's a lot about this that has like a Jurassic Park feel. And Jurassic Park is great, kind of bum 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 bum. But it's not. It doesn't do anything for you. It doesn't do anything. You look at it, 3 mana 3/3. I mean, I when I was looking at this card, thinking about this card, I was thinking, what would a 3 mana 3/3 have to have? And I don't want to get too into it or into it, but 3 mana 3/3 already. You're kind of thinking, but this card, no, definite myth, definite myth. All right, next up, the Dragon Whisperer. I lost the Dragon Whisperer. Oh, there we go. 2 red for a 2/2. 1 red, Dragon Whisperer gains flying until end of turn. 1 red, 1 other. Dragon Whisperer gets +1/+0 until end of turn. Formidable. 2 red, 4. Put a 4/4 red dragon creature token with flying onto the battlefield. Activate this ability only if creatures you control have total power 8 or greater.
Yeah, this card works for me as a hit.
Really?
Yes, absolutely.
I've gone back and forth on this card. This is probably One of the trickier ones, I think I go myth.
Okay.
I think and the weird thing is, if this was maybe I have a small creature bias in hit or myth. If this was a two red enchantment that pumped out dragons, for some reason I think that would be a hit for me.
But it works so much better as a creature. Like, it tells a story of, it's just this random guy who, you know, spends his time communing with the dragons and
sure.
and is able to get powers from them. He's able to, you know, figure out how to fire breathe and jump like a dragon. And, you know, after it's spent enough time with them, it gets the ability to call them to his aid in battle.
I mean, it's a great story. I don't know that it's...
Like, that flavor is not there as an enchantment.
No, I agree.
Enchantment, this if it's just six mana make a dragon, that's just...
You might have me. It has this weird feel. I mean, I love the story. I love the flavor. I love everything the card represents.
Okay.
I don't know, that's really a mythic story. Kind of Sarkhan story, going crazy. I touched Nicol Bolas. I went mad. I released the Eldrazi. I did all this crazy stuff. And then I decided to go back in time and bring dragons back because why not? That is an epic story. I'm some crazy dude that nobody liked except for the dragons. So I hung out with them. I learned their secrets. And now they come to me. I don't know. I'm sticking with myth. All right. Next up, Narset Transcendent. Now, Planeswalkers, it's not an Elder Dragon problem. It's really the Planeswalker problem, because it's really, really hard, unless we're talking about Tybalt again, to really find a non-mythic feel to a Planeswalker. It does happen, but I don't really think Narset is a good example of that. One blue, one white, two other. Just freaking loyalty six. Okay. Plus one, look at the top card of your library. If it's a non-creature, non-land card, you may reveal it and put it into your hand. Minus two, when you cast your next instant or sorcery spell from your hand this turn, it gains rebound. Minus nine, you get an emblem with your opponents can't cast non-creature spells.
Yeah.
I mean...
It's obviously a hit.
Obviously a hit. Flavor perspective. See, this is okay.
There's no person this card is not a hit for.
No, it's absolutely a hit.
Yeah,
that as soon as you saw it.
Well, yeah, from the story perspective, like Narset died, and then you get to come back to this alternate timeline, and she gets reborn as this ultimate badass planeswalker.
This is
like,
a mythic story. Yeah. Okay, this is. She died. Sarkhan had a thing for her. He goes back in time. He protects Ugin in this Zendikarian crystal. Comes back like, hey guys, oh my gosh, dragons are back. Oh my gosh, Narset, where are you? And she's a total outcast, obviously, because she remembers, I think, the actual timeline. Don't know, haven't read the book yet, don't spoil it. But yes, it is, I mean, the story and the feel of Narset Transcendent is, I think, everything you want out of a real mythic planeswalker. It's a real mythic feel. Not just another Jace, Lilian of the Veil I love, but not just another reprinted planeswalker, but a really kind of mythic feel to the planeswalker.
Yeah, I like that she's tied to her home. Like she ties in with Rebound. Like
right.
She's not a planeswalker visiting this right. plane. Like this is her home, and she says that on the card.
Yes, that's what's great. She is Tarkirian.
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Okay, we'll go with Tarkirian. Well, there you go, Narset Transcendent. Okay, next up, Ojutai Exemplars, two white, two other, for a 4/4 human monk. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, choose one. Tap target creature. Ojutai Exemplars gains first strike and lifelink until end of turn, or exile Ojutai Exemplars, then return it to the battlefield tapped under its owner's control.
I'm going to go with hit.
Really? Interesting.
Yeah. I love the art.
The art's great.
The art is fantastic on this card.
Yeah.
Really, this card just does so much.
It does. It's kind of like a charm creature.
Exactly.
Right? I mean, it's like all the modal stuff you can do with it. Certainly from a playability standpoint, you can imagine the complex game states this card represents. I'm going to go myth. It doesn't feel... It's a 4-mana 4/4. I really have a creature bias.
Yeah.
I really have a creature bias when it comes... It seems great. I think certainly from a playability standpoint, there's a lot of unique things. I mean, it's weird in Modern Magic to say it's a 4-mana 4/4 and not say, well, hey, wow, immediately, of course, playable, but that's not the way Modern Magic works. But yeah, it doesn't seem too much like a hit to me. I'm definitely coming down myth on this.
It's not the size of the creature that matters, Mashi. It's how well you use it.
Wise words from Josh Utter Layton, everybody. Next up, Risen Executioner. Two black, two other for a 4/3. Risen Executioner can't block. Other zombie creatures you control get +1/+1. You may cast Risen Executioner from your graveyard if you pay one colorless more to cast it for each other creature card in your graveyard.
This is a myth. This is just a zombie lord.
Yeah.
The lords are just not mythic creatures. There's nothing mythic about them. And certainly just, like, I don't know how being able to return from your graveyard to play has become, like apparently that's enough to make a card mythic now, because we have this card and the raptor, but it just doesn't work as a mythic ability for me.
For the record, I'm a myth on this one, too. But it does raise an interesting question, because I do think, I mean, one of the things you said is, like, it's just a lord. And that's part of the factor of how you rank it as a hit or myth. But there's a certain amount where, if we didn't know lords and they were new now, I think there is a mythic feel to them. Of course, we know them.
But we do know them. They've been around forever in
so
many different forms. You can't just divorce it from
all
of Magic history.
Which is why I give it a myth. Easy myth. Yeah. But it made me think there is a way. There is some type of lord apparatus.
If there was the first lord Magic has ever seen, that might feel mythic.
I think that definitely would feel mythic. But since we're not there, there would be some bonus, some type of lord-like structure that would, and this is not it, but I mean something, I don't know, would be +3/+3. That seems kind of arbitrary, but some.
Oh, you
type
can certainly
of
make
effect,
a. You can certainly like, make a like the +1/+1 ability on a card that would feel mythic. I mean, but this is not it.
Even something like Imperious Perfect, where it's like +1/+1, and it generates the tokens. I mean, I'm not saying that's a hit, but mm-hmm. that kind of feel. There's a way to innovate lords to get them to be a hit. This ain't it. So.
Yeah, something like Coral Helm Commander, maybe.
Yes. Definitely. See, but yeah. Enough said on this. Definitely, definitely a myth. All right, next up, Sarkhan Unbroken. Another Tarkirian.
Well, he's not originally from Tarkir,
I think he's
right?
originally from Tarkir. Yeah, this is his home plane.
Okay.
This is homeboy's backyard.
Oh, wow.
So here we go. Red, blue, green, two other for 4 loyalty planeswalker. +1, draw a card, then add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool. -2, put a 4/4 red dragon creature token with flying onto the battlefield. -8, search your library for any number of dragon creature cards and put them into the battlefield, then shuffle your library. Hit or myth?
Yeah, obviously it's a hit.
Yeah, obviously it's a hit. Yeah,
first of all, even ignoring that he's a planeswalker.
It says +1, draw a card.
That's the least exciting mode on the card.
Are you kidding me? You get to draw a card for free every turn.
For -1 mana every turn. And that's the least exciting thing he does.
You think -2 is that much? Well, I guess.
That's his default mode. It was this 5 mana Broodmate Dragon. No big deal.
You think if he had another -2 ability, that +1 wouldn't be enough to really push you over the edge? It's drawing a card. Do you know how valuable drawing cards is?
I do. Actually.
It's a card game, Raptor. You know, you want to draw more cards. No, but I agree. The second one is clearly the better ability. I'm like scared to check the chat because I took such a strong line on Sarkhan being Tarkirian. I think I was so wrong about Yawgmoth, and I'm like, don't check the chat, Mosh. You could be wrong. No, but I'm pretty sure I'm good on that one. Sarkhan Unbroken, definite hit. Raptor, you've got that a hit. It's a planeswalker. Yeah. I mean,
but given that a planeswalker is always going to be a hit, even ignoring that, Sarkhan works as a hit.
He feels great. Yeah. He feels like an absolute like monster of a planeswalker. So I definitely feel good there. Okay, next up. Shaman of Forgotten Ways. 1/2 for a 2/3. Tap to add 2 mana in any combination of colors to your mana pool. Spend this mana only to cast creature spells. Formidable for 2/9. Tap. Each player's life total becomes the number of creatures he or she controls.
I don't know. So Biorhythm, 100% mythic.
Yeah.
Or like 100%
hit. It'd be a hit all the way.
Like...
Biorhythm.
Sticking it onto just a creature, like, problem is that, like, the default mode for this guy is not casting that, because it's just, like, that's the dream, but it seems, like, so unrealistic of a dream.
It's not going to happen. I like how you're suddenly on the same wavelength I was for Dragon Whisperer, because I agree.
Well, no.
This card's
Well, for Dragon Whisperer, you were playing that card to make dragons with him. Like, that's what he does. He whispers to dragons, calls them to his side. That's what the card does.
I get that, but what I'm saying is...
Like, this card, in reality, it doesn't actually cast Biorhythm.
No, but
if that was, like, the thing it did that you're mostly trying to do with it, it would work for me as a hit.
Fair enough, but if it was just Biorhythm, you'd be saying hit, right? I would be saying hit, you'd be saying hit, everybody would be saying hit.
Yeah, that's obviously a hit.
Yeah, but so Shaman of Forgotten Ways...
The problem is that the main mode for this card is just a mana creature.
Only for creature spells.
Yeah, and that's clearly a myth. Just not, that's just not definitely, even definitely. In the realm of, like...
Yeah.
I'm going to give this a myth. As a mana creature, obviously nowhere in the realm of possibility. The dream of casting Biorhythm, like, which is it makes dream. It close. Like, it's close for me. It is a sweet dream, but I just don't see that being realistic enough for that to be like a reason to like think of this card as that's what it does.
Feel, which yeah, it doesn't yeah. Have. Okay, and final up, Shorecrasher Elemental, for three blue for 3/3. One blue, exile Shorecrasher Elemental, then return it to the battlefield face down under its owner's control. For one colorless, Shorecrasher Elemental gets +1/-1 or -1/+1 until end of turn. Megamorph, one blue, 4. Yeah. Hit or myth?
Obviously a myth. This is just a tournament power level card that has no mythic feeling to it at all. Though, I will say, if it had actually been called Megamorphling, like it obviously should have been, then I could see it as a hit. Then it brings the sense of nostalgia, like,
is Morphling. In a similar way, like, this is a real borderline myth for me, because I am nostalgic, it does remind me of Morphling, and Morphling, you know, I mean, if they printed Morphling today, it would not be a hit from a playability standpoint, but I think the nostalgia and what Superman was when it was Superman would make it a hit for me. This is no Superman. Let's be clear on that. It's close.
Kind of looks like an Aquaman, though.
It does. Actually, it really does. And I think it obviously raises the question of mono blue devotion. So, I mean, from a tournament standpoint, from a playability standpoint, there's a lot going on with it that intrigues me. From a mythic standpoint, it's just not. I didn't think about the Megamorphling thing, but if they had actually worked in Morphling somewhere here, that probably would have been enough for me to make it a hit.
I mean, maybe it's just supposed to be Megamorphling in our heads, and you know.
Well, I think it is.
Well, it is that. Yeah, but yeah. I mean, maybe they're just counting on that to give it, you know, that mythic sense to it anyway.
But Wizards of the Coast is not afraid to be tongue in cheek. There's Tassinger hanging from Silmar's neck here.
Yeah,
right?
I really don't understand why this card is not called Megamorphling.
I don't either. If anyone from WotC is out there, please, we want to know. The people want to know. Why isn't this Megamorphling? It is Megamorphling, just not called Megamorphling. So there you have it. That's our hit or myth for the Dragons of Tarkir mythics. A little bit on the tame side, just because those darn Elder Dragons, you know, ended up being hits across the board. But
too many hits.
Too many great mythics in this set. Too much mythic. But yeah, I mean, what are you going to do? They're Elder Dragons, man. Elder Dragons can be an Elder Dragon. So there you have it. That is the main part of our Magic TV for this week. Of course, we still have this week's top 8. Woo.